Welcome to the Blazor Image Editor tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor component. This component features a user-friendly and efficient interface for image editing. You can easily open and edit the images. With built-in tools, you can smoothly zoom, crop, add annotations, and rotate image. Additionally, you can export images in different formats like JPEG, PNG, and SVG. First, I will show you how to create Blazor web app. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application and provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project and have selected the auto render mode for both server and WebAssembly apps under the interactive render mode section. Apart from this, there are four other modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now, the application is ready to use. Next, let's proceed to add the Blazor Image Editor component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So, let me open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor package, and install the latest version. Also, I install the Themes NuGet package to host the CSS and script files. After installation, let me navigate to the Imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor namespace to use the component within the Pages folder. Next, I open the client-side program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Blazor Image Editor component. Also, ensure that the Syncfusion service is registered in the server-side program CS file. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component to host the script and refer to the CSS for the component. Here, everything is configured, so open the Home Razor component. Remove the default code and define the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor component. The default height of the Image Editor component is 100%, so I set the height property to 400. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the Blazor Image Editor includes a file browser icon and a Browse Here option. You can use either one to easily upload an image from your local path. Additionally, you can also drag and drop your image here. Now I am using the file browser icon. I click the browser icon and select an image from the local path. You can see the component displayed with the selected image. Notice that the toolbar is enabled with editing options. Using the zoom in option, you can zoom in on the image and move the zoomed region both horizontally and vertically with the pan option. You can zoom out of the zoomed region using the zoom out option. Next, I am going to crop the image. So let me choose the crop option in the toolbar and select the custom drop down. This drop-down opens with different options like custom, circle, square, and various aspect ratios. Here, I select the image region using the circle option and adjust the image. Then, select the apply option. Notice that the image is cropped to that circle region. If you want to revert this, select the undo option. See, the image is uncropped. Select the redo option and the image will be cropped again. Next, I'll show you some of the ways to edit the image. First, click the annotation option. A pop-up opens with different options to add annotations to the image. I add text to the image. Select the place where I want to add the text. Then drag the selected place to the required size and add the text. After that, click on the Apply icon. If you want to know more about this annotation option, check the documentation link in the description. Next, I'm going to rotate the image to the left. So let me click the Crop and Transform option and choose Rotate Left. See, the image is now rotated to the left. Similarly, you can also rotate the image to the right and flip the image in both horizontal and vertical directions. Additionally, if you want to rotate the image as needed, use the Straighten slider. When I move it right or left, the image rotates accordingly. Next, if you want to fine-tune the imported image, select the Fine-Tune option. Within these options, I have more choices such as brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, and so on. In this case, let me proceed to increase the contrast in our imported image. Notice that the contrast is increased. Next, if you want to filter the image, select the filter option. There are 7 filters are available here. In this case, I use the cold filter and apply the changes. Notice that the image is changed to cold filter. Next, if you want to use a frame in your image, select the frame icon. See that the frame icon is disabled because the image is cropped as a circle. The frame feature works with square or rectangular images, so I change a crop from a circle to a square. Now I try to use the frame again and see that the option is enabled. There are 5 frames available. You can also customize the color, gradient, and size of the selected frame. In this case, let me use the bevel frame and customize the color, gradient, and size of the frame. Next, if you want to change the height or width, select the resize option and adjust it as needed. Finally, if you want to save the edited image, select the Save button. Notice that you can change the name of the image. In this case, I set the name as Image Editor. Also, you can change the format to PNG, JPEG, or SVG. I set the format to JPEG and adjust the quality as needed. Click the Quality Settings icon and you will see a slider instead of a quality button. Move the slider to the right or left to increase or decrease the quality of the image. Then click the Download button and notice that the edited image is downloaded with a provided name and format. Apart from these options, you can reset the changes in the editor using the Reset option. That's it. I've shown you basic editing options available in the toolbar and how they work. If you want to know more about the editing options, you can check our documentation page given in the description below. Next, let me show you how to initially load an image in the image editor. Here, you can initially load an image using a hosted link, online URL, image data, or base64. For this demo, I open the image using a hosted link. So let me add the code block. Here, I declare an image editor instance named image and bind it to the ref attribute within the image editor component. Using this reference, you can access built-in methods like select async, open async, export async, and so on. Additionally, define the image editor events and define the created event. This event triggers when the image is created. Then create the private async method named openAsync. Inside the method, check if the image editor instance is not null. If it is, call the built-in openAsync method. Pass the Blazor demo image URL link as an argument to this openAsync method. Then bind it to the created event. Look here, the image editor is displayed with the image from the online URL link. Next, I will show you how to access an image from your local project files. To do this, first, place the downloaded image in the www root folder. Next, I remove the existing hosted link. Pass the image name to the openAsync method. Now you can see the image editor displaying the image from your project. Let me summarize. I demonstrated how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Image Editor component and explored the various editing options available. Additionally, I showed you how to initially load an image in different ways. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.